Yo guys, what is going on? It is your boy Cyrix here, welcome back to another video. Today we'll show you the different skeleton types and their weaknesses in Sea of Thieves. Enjoy! Some tips before the actual video starts. Skeletons can eat bananas to heal themselves. Skeletons can spawn with their hands, a cutlass, a blunderbuss or a pistol. Also make sure to kill the skeletons who have guns first or use normal skeletons to cover from the shots. The bone skeleton is your standard enemy that can appear just about everywhere. These skeletons are by far the easiest to kill. A skeleton wearing a piece of clothing like the bandana, eye patch or armband are exactly the same as the regular bone skeletons, but they have more health and are more aggressive. These skeletons are usually found during Order of Souls voyages or during Skull Forts. A plant skeleton is exceptionally tough. Their leafy cover acts as a sort of body armor, which is strengthened whenever they touch water. Keep these skeletons away from water at all costs, else their body armor will refresh. When out of the water, they will dry up and get weaker. The shadow skeletons, sometimes called ghosts, are invulnerable whenever it is nighttime, and the only way to make them vulnerable is to equip the lantern and raise it up. The shadow skeleton will immediately react, recoiling from the light while their bodies become whole. With the release of the Four of the Damned came new types of shadow skeletons. These skeletons have different colored eyes, and the only way to make them vulnerable is to match your lantern color to their eyes. Thankfully, if you've started the Four of the Damned, you can quickly change your lantern color by going into the arena and finding the right statue. Gold skeletons are the toughest skeleton types in Sea of Thieves. It will take a lot of blunderbuss shots, cannonballs and explosives to kill them, unless you know their weakness, water. Throw a bucket of water on a gold skeleton or lead them to the ocean and watch them rust. Once the gold skeleton is rusty, use one of the three gun types to kill them. A blunderbuss is by far the best option, and if you stay very close to them and aim for the head, they will be down with a single shot. Killing these is as simple as taking aim with a weapon and shooting the gunpowder barrel, causing it to explode, taking down the skeleton and any surrounding skeletons. Corralling a group of gunpowder skeletons together and causing one to explode will set off a tremendous chain reaction, so be careful. Now that stronghold gunpowder barrels have been added to Sea of Thieves, you might find that some skeletons pop up carrying one. If you shoot precisely, you can destroy the skeleton without setting off the barrel, which can then be sold for several thousand gold. Each of the skeleton types has a captain variant. This is a bigger version of the skeleton that retains the same attributes as its smaller minions. A gold skeleton captain will be weaker to water. A shadow skeleton captain must have light shined on it, etc. Skeleton captains will only appear after their minions have been slain. So use this to your advantage by keeping one minion alive if you need time to recover and get resources. Also, they are easily spotted by the unique hat they wear and the big orange name above their head. To defeat a skeleton boss, bring a lot of firepower. Consider using blunderbusses, gunpowder barrels and even cannonballs. While attacking them, look out for their own attacks. They can slam two chests together, knocking you back and dealing huge damage. Summon more skeletons to fight on their behalf and even teleport.
If you enjoyed my video, I would appreciate if you subscribe to my channel and leave a like. You can also check out my social media at @imcyrex on Twitter and Instagram. Have a nice day, and I hope I will see you again.